What is estimate to complete in EVM? You might know the definition of estimate to complete or ETC, but do you understand the formulas? Let's decipher ETC formulas. Hey, this is Praveen Malik from PMbyPM.com. I have made it my mission to help you pass the PMP exam in your first try. In this video, I'm going to talk about ETC with the help of an example. I'll also explain ETC formulas. Stay tuned till this end of this video and I'll explain some real life scenarios. Before we go ahead, please subscribe to this channel and click on bell icon. This way, whenever I release a new informative video, you'll get an instant notification. So what is estimate to complete? The definition is expected cost to finish the remaining project work. Money needed to complete the remaining project work. The keyword here is remaining project work. So let's understand what is remaining project work. On control date, some work would have been finished while some other would be remaining. Control date is any date in between the project where you are measuring the performance of the project. So if you look at this diagram, green signifies the completed work, whereas the blue signifies the remaining work. The remaining work is equal to total work minus completed work. Simple. Let's go back to our example project. The plan was to build 80 tables in 5 days. Our estimate was that it will take us $1,000 to build one table. The total budget or BAC came out to be $80,000. You can click on the card above to see the details of this example project. This is the detailed plan of our example project. It depicts the equivalence between scope, time and cost. Let's consider day 3 as our control date. On day 3, we had planned to build 17 tables and a total of 40 tables by the end of day 3. Let's look at the current status. So on day 3, 15 tables were built and a total of 35 tables were built at the end of day 3. So clearly, we are not going as per the plan. We are behind the plan. We still have to build 45 more tables. Now that we have understood the remaining work, let's understand the monetary value of remaining work. In EVM terminology, there are two important monetary values. Monetary value of the total work is budget at completion or BAC. Monetary value of the completed work is earned value or EV. So let's look at this diagram. Green signifies the completed work or the earned value. Blue signifies the remaining work or the monetary value of the remaining work. So monetary value of the remaining work is equal to monetary value of the total work minus monetary value of the completed work. We can write a small formula. MV of remaining work is equal to BAC minus EV. So let's look at our example project from the perspective of monetary values. So on day 3, we had planned to complete 40 tables. The monetary value of these tables was $40,000. But in fact, we had completed only 35 tables. And the monetary value came out to be $35,000. So 45 tables are still to be built and the monetary value of these tables is $45,000. Now let's calculate ETC. Is ETC equal to monetary value of the remaining work? No. Why? The ETC depends on the project team's efficiency of utilizing the money. The keyword here is efficiency of utilizing the money. Let's understand what does this means. So let's go back to our example project. At the end of day 3, 35 out of 80 tables were built. We already know the cost of building these tables was $36,000. 45 tables were still to be built. Now we have to estimate the cost of these remaining tables. Let's look at it pictorially. At the end of day 3, 35 tables were built. The earned value was $35,000, but it actually costed $36,000. So there was a small variation. We should have spent $35,000 to build 35 tables as per our original estimates, but we actually spent $36,000. Now let us look at the remaining work. So 45 tables are still to be built. The monetary value of these 45 tables is $45,000 as per our original estimate. But ETC could be different from $45,000. It could be less than $45,000. It could be equal to $45,000. Or it could be more than $45,000. We still have to figure it out. What it means is, for building the remaining 45 tables, we might spend less or equal or more than our original estimate. Let's calculate it. So we have already done work worth of $35,000 and it costed us $36,000. We have to do work worth of $45,000 and we have to find out the cost of remaining work. Let's go back to our school mathematics days. This is a simple ratio and proportion problem. The remaining work will cost us 36,000 divided by 35,000 into $45,000. So whatever that comes out to be. Let's reverse engineer this figure. So ETC is equal to 36,000 divided by 35,000 into 45,000. Let's rewrite it mathematically. So we can rewrite it as 45,000 in the numerator and 35,000 divided by 36,000 in the denominator. Now, the numerator is monetary value of the remaining work, whereas the denominator is CPI or cost performance index. So the formula comes out to be ETC is equal to monetary value of remaining work divided by cost efficiency. This is our current cost efficiency, but it may change in future. Let's rewrite the ETC formula as ETC is equal to MV of remaining work divided by future projected cost efficiency. Let's derive the formula further. Let's look at the numerator. So numerator is MV of remaining work, which is equal to BAC minus EV. So the ETC formula can be rewritten as BAC minus EV divided by future projected cost efficiency. Now let us look at the denominator. So in EVM, cost efficiency is represented as cost performance index or CPI. But CPI is our current efficiency. The future projected cost efficiency could be different. Let us call it CPIP. So our formula becomes ETC is equal to BAC minus EV divided by CPIP. So generic ETC equation could be ETC is equal to BAC minus EV divided by CPIP. Let us look at some real life scenarios. Scenario number one, the project team believes that the remaining work can be completed as originally planned. Scenario number two, the project team believes that the future efficiency of completing the remaining work will be same as the past efficiency. Scenario number three, the project team believes that the remaining work should be replanned. Let us understand these scenarios in a little bit more detail. Scenario number one, the project team believes that the project's past performance will not affect the future performance. That is, the irregularities of the past would not be repeated in future. The remaining work would be completed at project's 100% cost efficiency. That is, as per the original estimates. So we can replace CPIP with 100% in the generic ETC equation. So the generic ETC equation would become ETC equal to BAC minus EV. So for our example, ETC is equal to 80,000 minus 35,000, which is equal to 45,000, which simply means that the project team will require $45,000 to build the remaining 45 tables. Let's look at the second scenario. The project team believes that the project's past performance will continue to affect the future performance. That is, the project would continue to expend money at the current rate. The remaining work would be completed at project's past cost efficiency. Replacing CPIP with CPI, the generic ETC equation becomes BAC minus EV divided by CPI. For our example project, after calculation, the ETC comes out to be $46,286. It simply means that the project team will require $46,286 to build the remaining 45 tables. Let's look at a third scenario. The project team believes that the project's past performance will not affect the future performance. The project team also believes that the project would expend money neither at the current rate nor at 100%. So it could be something different. The remaining work would be completed at a new cost efficiency. The generic equation remains the same. So let's do some calculations. Let us assume that the project team has learned something from the past and they think that the future cost efficiency can be improved. They determine that the future cost efficiency would be 120% or 1.2. Putting 1.2 in the formula, we get $37,500. It simply means that the project team will require $37,500 to build the remaining 45 tables. So I have written a full post on some of the other scenarios. You can follow the link in the description below to look at the other scenarios. I have a question for you. Which of the following is true about BAC? BAC and ETC are same at the beginning of a project. BAC is equal to AC plus ETC at any juncture in the middle of a project. BAC is equal to EV plus ETC at any juncture in the middle of a project. BAC is equal to CV plus AC plus ETC at any juncture in the middle of a project. I'm curious to know about your opinion. Please comment below. So this was my fourth video in the playlist. Thank you for watching this. Now you can click on the next video to understand EAC.